We are now in CorPower's machine hall in Västberga in southern Stockholm. And here we are assembling and testing our first commercial scale wave energy converter, the CorPower C4. So CorPower, we are a developer of wave energy converters with a new type of high efficiency machines that converts ocean waves into electricity. So the challenge with wave energy, why haven't we seen commercial wave energy in the world until today, has been to design devices that are, number one, robust enough to survive the toughest storm in the ocean, and number two, to produce enough electricity compared to their size and cost. And historically, devices have either broken in storms, or they've just been too large or too costly compared to what they could produce. But we've taken a dramatic step in improving that. So we made these devices that are naturally transparent and protected in storms, and that produce about 5 times as much energy per the amount of equipment that you need to install in the ocean to do it. So it radically improves the competitiveness of wave energy and makes it very robust.
So since our device is in the ocean and in pretty harsh conditions, we can deal with some vibration, and so we like our sensors to be very vibration resistant. Also, since we don't like to go there, it's pretty far out, we want to have remote access to all of our device information, both for control and for monitoring purposes. So we use the IO master, EtherCAT IO link IO master, and we use pressure sensors, temperature sensors, flow level sensors, humidity, and electronic circuit breakers, and we have all our sensors connected. So we have direct access through the IO link communication to all our sensors and get the most data out of those. We're now in a dry test mode, and so we are simulating the movement of the ocean onto our device, and we analyze the data that's coming back from the device, all the sensors, and through the IO master. We're using here also moneo to set up the devices and to analyze some of the data coming back from it.
We start our cooperation with FM when it was located in university. We're looking for a supplier to have a possibility to do the monitor of the system. Based on that, we see EFM have everything, and this was the reason to actively choose that.